competing with our mousetrap cars to see which one goes the furthest.
Go, 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 go!
We expect them to do at least 16 feet.
Ah! How about it? Go!
You have 3 chances. We take the highest.
This is Introduction to Engineering. It is a class designed to bring mathematics, a little bit of the physics, a little bit of material science and principles of engineering as an intro for those students that will be moving on into engineering programs.
Our final project of the class, we were asked to build a car powered by mousetraps. We were given a list of supplies we could use.
Mousetrap, a pencil.
Wooden dowels, a ton of hot glue.
Paper.
Cardboard. Rubber bands.
Washers.
Paper clips.
CDs.
And pantyhose.
It was about a total of maybe 20 items you were allowed to use.
Part of the physics aspect of it, that it had to have a load. The load happens to be a golf ball.
Are you just taping the golf ball to it, or are you having
That's it? Cheesing it, but okay.
No, it's not. It'll, hey.
It does you fake it till you make it.
They are developing a vehicle that is entirely driven by mechanically stored energy.
There you go. There you go.
Go, 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 go.
We usually give them this project from the second week in the semester, so they have the full semester to really work on it. And it shows, the people who worked on it early, it shows of how much they put effort on it and actually develop it.
So I actually made the wheels out of mousetraps. Each wheel combines 9 mousetraps that were glued together. And once they were cured, I cut them out and actually turned them on a makeshift lathe.
What I did is I put zip ties so the axle would still spin even with the mousetrap on it. So once you pull the spring up, it'll go and it'll wrap up tighter. And then you'll let it go and the spring will just pull the rope and the axle spins and just carries everything along with it.
Because safety is a big part of engineering, and I talked to our teacher about using eggs next year instead, the pantyhose keeps it secure, but it also, if it does get impacted, it's like a seat belt.
20. Oh gosh, what happened there, guys? The purpose of this is really design. He's going to first gear, second gear, and third gear. So we basically trying to have them think outside the box, what can I do to put it together and get 16, 20, 30 feet.
You use the mousetrap, you actually wind the string up on the axle. The mousetrap then pulls on the spring and spins the axle, making the vehicle roll.
So it's really the idea of the thinking besides homework, besides paper, besides the thinking of how to develop this vehicle and how to test it and how to run.
It gave us a hands-on look at engineering, not just on paper, not just on the computer.
You may have an idea and it's not necessarily going to work out. You're going to have to try an idea and adjust your plan based on the results, which is how everything we use is designed. Very few things ever worked out on the first try.
Go left, go left, go left.
Oh, I know the problem.
Well, my car broke this morning, so I had to re-engineer the whole firing system. And a friend of mine in class just gave me a spare mousetrap he had. So hopefully I actually have some power.
It not only has a competition, but teamwork. They are helping each other out. All those aspects are what you would hope to see in an all-around, well-rounded engineer 5 years down the road when he joined the workforce.